So the BioDiscovery Institute was formed to bring together some of the top plant science researchers at UNT behind a focus that was going to both advance science at UNT and also forge links with industry.
The big picture of where plant science is now and where it is going depends on your perspective and really your imagination, the level of your imagination.
The interactions between research and industry are very much a two-way street. Sometimes industry will come to a university group of researchers because that group is the best people in the world or in the region with particular sets of skills that they may be able to use. At other times, scientists maybe have ideas based on their basic science and are looking for some kind of application. Many projects in the Institute tie into this idea of plants as factories and improving plants as factories.
The real exciting thing, though, is to do this in a way that it does not compete with our food sources. So we need to grow plants for food, obviously, and we don't want our materials or products or fuels to compete with our food sources. And so it's a challenge to be able to harvest all of the materials from the crop rather than just the food or just the products. And so I see that as the real opportunity for the future.
The real beauty of basic research, which is what I'm doing, I'm looking to understand a fundamental process, cell division, is that once we understand that process and know all the proteins that are involved and how they're regulated, then that's something that other scientists can come back and manipulate. And so some of the ways that we're looking to improve corn is to improve the productivity of the corn, and now that we're, you know, in this phase of active climate change, to make corn that's more robust, not only in the kernel area, but also to make them more resistant to drought, insects, fungi, bacteria, all those sort of things that can become much more problematic when a corn plant is no longer growing in perfect, optimal conditions.
The work that I do in my laboratory is focused on a sort of a class of molecules called lipids. And lipids have about two times the amount of energy as the same amount of carbohydrate or protein. What we would like to do is to be able to produce those lipids in parts of plants or in tissues of plants where they don't normally accumulate. I think the near-term application for engineering lipids in plants is probably going to be from these fatty acid products that are used for industrial purposes. And the scale or the need for the amount of those products fits very well with how much we can produce in agriculture. So
you want a co-product which has high value but also requires very, very high volume. So being able, for example, to make carbon fibers out of lignin would be the perfect type of co-product that could go with a bioethanol plant. And those are some of the projects we're trying to develop within the Institute. But it's more than likely there's going to be a whole revolution in plant engineering.